Hello and welcome to Misery Mire. And for once, I'm in a good mood. Really, why shouldn't I be? I mean, Starman's show seems to be working fine. The Princess's show flopped badly that it's now officially cancelled. And I made this level in under 20 minutes. So, let's move along with it.
How pleasant. Bobbing along on the bottom of the beautiful briny sea. What a chance to get to bed to peep at the plants and creatures of the deep. We glide far below the rolling tide.
Okay, so level 8 kind of starts you off with this jump here. And you get 5,000 points just for entering the water. And this is mostly the main part of the level. Trying to catch these stupid pibbly fish. The ones you mostly want to catch are the yellow ones. Because they automatically, I believe, add one tail piece. And I have no idea why I'm frantically running around. I should have gotten the tongue extension right there long ago. This level has no enemies in it, but except for that little one down on the bottom, that thing ticking away there. Yeah, your clock is gonna kill you. There's also one other way to lose, and that's if you run out of pibblies. There's not an infinite amount of pibblies here. Other than that, most of the level is just going from pond to pond, catching the pibbly fish. Which isn't as easy as it sounds. This 3D isometric view is not as easy to catch the fish as it seems. You'll notice I'm mostly trying to catch them from the edges. There's also a glitch, kind of? It's not really a glitch, but that's the only thing I can think of calling it. Happened a lot with NES games. If you shoot your tongue off the side of the screen, you can actually hit it on the other side of the screen. And I think I caught a fish at some point in time that way. I kinda just hope I did it in this video. Okay, you're running out of time already, so make sure you grab this clock down here. There are two clocks in this stage. You definitely want to get both. The black pibble fish are just annoying. You have to hit them 3 times before they'll become one of the gold ones. And also for a secret thing. Okay, it's not gonna go after it right now. There's a 1-up down on the bottom of the screen. Come on, fish! Get in my belly! There we go. Yes, make sure you jump over that. Perfect timing. And into the next pool. And those are instant death spikes in the background. Those are technically what I guess the spikes are in this game. Not the silver spiky thingies I called them last time. I think this is the area you're likely to run out of pibbles. Oh no, wait, there's one more down here. Trying to judge all 3 planes on this is just a migraine, actually. See? That's the tongue thing I was telling you about. and make sure you do not fall off the waterfall. Enter the door, and congratulations, level 8 is complete. Now just wait a good 20 minutes for this whole wrap-up thing to go through, and we'll move on to the next part of the episode. Yeah, I wasn't kidding about this, this takes a while. So, do you see where this level can be kind of a cinch? Anyway!
So, Oddball, how did I do with the pilot?
I'm not Oddball!
Oh, sorry, you sound the same. I got confused.
What the? I don't sound like Oddball!
Moving on!
Uh-oh. Running out of time. Let's go. Come on. Come on. Come on, I think there's a clock after this. Come on. Got it. Awesome. Alright, if I jump ahead and... No! Okay, and then after that, we can just leave the level. Awesome. And we're done. Okay, now to save this and... Uh-oh. Shoot! No! Come on. Okay, here, come on, we're nibbly fiddlies. Oops. Come here. Alright. What the? Oh, didn't know you could die that way. Whoops. You know, I just don't like hitting the jump button at that jump. I don't know why. Well, believe it or not on this one, I have to give this level a 5. Yeah, it's kind of up there with the difficulty, even though it doesn't look like it is. Mostly because I just remember that throughout this entire level, my heart was just racing throughout the whole thing to get it done. Very panicking, because there is a lot of ways to screw this level up, mostly with the timer being a main culprit, but the fact that you can actually run out of piblies kind of sucks as well, so you have to be careful that everything is going just right on the underwater segments. Also, be very careful of that final waterfall. Even if you're playing a regular game, be careful. There is another pool in this level, but getting to it, you kind of lose a life. Because, you run out of time in the pool. So I don't really know what's over there. Also, a good note is, I have no idea where the foot is in this level. I never actually seen it. Maybe it was over near the hidden passage, but I never saw the foot. This level is a good break between 7 and 9, but I really can't give it more than a 5. Man, I feel very good about this! So, what is the next level like?
What have I gotten myself into?
Les poissons, les poissons, how I love les poissons! Love to chop and to serve little fish. First I cut off their heads and I pull out their bones. Ah mais oui, ça c'est toujours délire. Les poissons, hi hi hi, ha ha ha. With a cleaver I hack them in two. I pull out what's inside and I serve it up fried. God, I love little fishes, don't you?